Strengths, he loves me in spite of it. You know, in one level or another, you're going to get judged. Even the kindest men have a judgment. God, you know, but God never does. He knows who you are from beginning to end, your intimate secrets, and he loves you anyway. You know, and I think that's one of the reasons I've seen David so close to God. Because David was actually rejected by his brothers, born on the wrong side of the sheets. Was pretty much the bastard child of Jesse. The one that everybody thought wasn't going to amount up to anything. You know, David's in the fields, and he just drawn near to his God, singing to his God, loving on his God. You know, and this song was taken from one of those experiences. And it's become one of my favorites. Lord has to do more of a work inside me. And this song basically started as a point where I'm crying out to God, Lord, do something in me, Lord. Lord, do something in me, Lord. Do something in me, Lord. Lord, I want to be somebody that changes the evil around me. I want to be someone that sets the soul free. Lord, do something in me. I studied Jeremiah, backward, upward, downward, forward, doing Bible studies, always led back to Jeremiah. Right? At one point the Lord told me, he said, you worship me, you don't worship Jeremiah. But now I worship Christ. But the example of this prophet really blows my mind away in strength, most of the passage.
I went around and I distributed some little shakers and musical instruments, so I don't think these guys will mind if you rock out.
Make some noise!
Rock out!
Yeah! Make joyful noise!
Ready for a joyful noise out there. So we're the artists formerly known as Wake the Dead. We are called the Jesus Circle. We can thank Dave, his son, for the name, because all our instruments we practice in his basement are in a circle, and he got a little upset that we were taking up his man space. So he said, got all this stuff here in the Jesus Circle, but we use it to our advantage, because now we use Matthew 18:20. It says, where there are two or three gathered in his name, there I am among them. And that's what Jesus said. So when you're in prayer, when you're together in fellowship, you're in your own Jesus Circle. All right, we're going to play a little song called Grace. You want to hear it? Here you go.
Yep.
You came to my rescue.
conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave, and we've been saved. He's conquered the grave. He's conquered the grave. We also have some online digital CDs you can purchase on iTunes, on Amazon Music, and Google Play. 10% of the proceeds go to the Community Cup for the New Avenue Foundations for this venture here that hopefully one day we can have a place where we can employ and train other people. So we are the Jesus Circle. The album is called Grace. And like I said, we're going to give some CDs away tonight. Any CD you purchase from us tonight that we have on hand is $5, and I'm going to donate the proceeds to the Community Cup tonight. So even if you don't have $5, even if it's $1, $0.50, whatever you got, if you want a CD, come see me. If you don't have any money, I'll still give you a CD, maybe. No, I'll give you a CD. You really want. All right, enough of the chat. This is called Hallelujah. There's two things that God wants us to do, and it can be the hardest two things in the world. The first thing is to trust Him, and the second thing is to obey Him. Those are the two biggest things that I've always had a problem with. But that's where faith comes in. Sometimes God doesn't want us to understand
Why? He just wants us to do what he asks us to do with no questions. And that's what faith is. To obey him is what means to love him. If you obey God, that means you love God, because it's a relationship. It's not a religion, it's not a ritual. To have a relationship with somebody goes both ways. God says you do, you ask for God, God does for you. It's not, God, I need this, I need this, I need this. It's, what do you want me to do, God? And you do what God asks, he'll bless you. Sometimes, if you don't do what he asks, he'll bless you. But most of all, he wants you to trust him. And that's why I wrote the song. got Colonel Sanders, I mean Mike Walker on bass. We like some chicken. He was available later. We got Gary on guitar. We're still trying to figure out our nickname tomorrow, but we'll just call him Gary for now. We got Dave and Shapiro on drums. So we want to thank Jim and Pam for having us here tonight. It's always a pleasure coming here because college is a safe place. It's a fun place. And we just like coming here. So if you like coming here, just keep coming. All right, this next song is called Rescue Me Be Still. Sometimes it's going to sound strange, but God just wants you to rest. He just wants you to stop, drop, and rest. No rolls. Stop, drop, and rest. Okay? That's what the Sabbath day is for. That is to rest. That is to worship God. And sometimes we forget that. Sometimes we're so busy in our lives that we forget the rest. So God says it's okay. You're allowed. You're allowed to take a day of rest. Make sure you do it, because if you get too busy, then you forget what to do. And that's what? Rest. Thank you.
God says, just rest in Him.
Things that unite us. Let us unite one another in love and Jesus. Let's start a revival with us.
need you as our Savior. We give you our life. Jesus, Jesus, we pray for our survival. Jesus, Jesus,
addiction. He took away all my pain and sorrow, and he made me a new person, he made me a new being. And because of Jesus, I'm with you today to tell you that he loves you, and he just wants a relationship with you. So this last song, before we get into the final, is called All of Me. God doesn't want 10% of you. God doesn't want 50%. He doesn't want 80%. When you give your life to Jesus, he wants 100%. He wants all of you. When you play poker and you see that you have a full house and you're going to beat everybody, he just wants you to be all in. God wants you to be all in. If you're a Christian tonight, if you follow Jesus, stop being a lukewarm Christian. Just be all in. Give everything to him, and he'll give everything back to you.
Thank you.
you. Continuing, because we can have heaven on earth if everyone works together, if everybody has the same mind and the same heart, and we can all accomplish the goals that we set out for us. If you want to contact us, like I said, we have the Facebook page. We also have an email address. You can always contact thejesuscircle@yahoo.com, and I usually answer your email. As long as it's not like 2 or 3 in the morning, well, maybe I might be up sometimes, but. If anybody else would like the CD, either want a paper one or want a free one, come see me afterwards, and we'll get to make sure you get the CD tonight. And again, we just want to thank everyone for being part of this. We are the Jesus Circle. Our CD is called Grace. It is on iTunes. It is on Google Play. And it's also on Amazon Music right now for digital download. And again, 10% of all the sales go right to this cause here. They go right to New Avenue Foundation to help with the, you know, establishing businesses to train and employ special needs people. So, thank you again. And hopefully they'll house out again. Hopefully we're not too noisy for you. I know, some people think we're a little loud. I know I got a big mouth, but at least, now I'm using it for a good cause. So, you guys want to get up and make some noise, grab some noisemakers and tambourines, and this is a joy song. So, if you want to get up out of your seat, go on, let me see, get busy, all right? This is called All I Want to Do is Worship You, and it goes a little something like this. Yeah.